Did you know that there are two equations that you can use to convert from polar to rectangular coordinates, and two equations that you can use to convert from rectangular to polar coordinates? I'll tell you all about these equations and walk through some example problems of converting a point from polar to rectangular coordinates and from rectangular to polar coordinates. Welcome to Understand the Math. We've created free guided notes that you can use as you watch this video and placed a link to them in the video description below. There's space in the notes where you can fill out the answers to the examples that we're going to do, because you can't just watch someone do math. You need to do it too. We'll begin by understanding the relationship between polar and rectangular coordinates and find out what the equations are that we need to use to convert between these two coordinate systems. A point can be written in rectangular coordinates in terms of x and y. X is the number of units to the right or left of the origin, and y is the number of units above or below the origin. The same point can also be written in polar coordinates in terms of r and theta. R is the distance from the point to the origin, and theta is the angle measured from the positive x-axis to the line segment connecting the origin to the point. Let's now look at the relationship between x and y and r and theta. We know from the Pythagorean theorem that x squared plus y squared is equal to r squared. If we take the square root of both sides, we find that r is equal to the square root of x squared plus y squared. We also know that tangent of theta is equal to the opposite side over the adjacent side, so it's equal to y over x. We can solve this equation for theta, and we get that theta is the inverse tan of y divided by x. Cosine theta is equal to the adjacent side divided by the hypotenuse, so it's equal to x over r. If we solve this equation for x, we get x is equal to r cosine theta. In a similar way, we know that sine theta is the opposite side divided by the hypotenuse, so it's equal to y divided by r. If we solve this equation for y, we get y is equal to r sine theta. These are the two equations that we're going to use when we convert a point from polar to rectangular coordinates. And these are the two equations that we're going to use when we convert a point from rectangular to polar coordinates. Let's now walk through two examples of converting a point from polar to rectangular coordinates. These are the two equations that we'll need to use. Our first example is the point 4, pi over 6. R is equal to 4, and our theta is equal to pi over 6. We want to write this point in terms of x and y. Our x is r cosine theta, so that's equal to 4 times cosine pi over 6. This gives us 4, and the cosine of pi over 6 is root 3 over 2. So our x is equal to 2 root 3. Y is equal to r sine theta. This is equal to 4 sine pi over 6. So we have a 4, and then sine pi over 6 is 1 half. So this gives us a y value of 2. Our point in rectangular coordinates is 2 root 3, comma 2. The second example that we'll look at is the point root 2 minus pi over 4. R is equal to root 2, and our theta is equal to minus pi over 4. X is equal to r cosine theta, which is root 2 times cosine minus pi over 4. This then becomes root 2 minus pi over 4 is in the fourth quadrant, So the cosine of minus pi over 4 is root 2 over 2, which simplifies to 1. Y is equal to r sine theta. This is equal to root 2 times sine minus pi over 4. The sine of minus pi over 4 is minus root 2 over 2. So we have root 2 times minus root 2 over 2, which gives us a value of minus 1. Our point in rectangular coordinates is equal to 1 minus 1. We'll now walk through two examples of converting a point from rectangular to polar coordinates. Our formula to find r is the square root of x squared plus y squared. If our point is located in the first quadrant, our formula to find theta is equal to the inverse tan of y over x. If our point is in the second, third, or fourth quadrants, we need to use a formula that has the reference angle theta sub r in it. Theta sub r is the inverse tan of the absolute value of y divided by x. We then can find theta from our reference angle chart. If our point is in quadrant 2, our angle is going to be pi minus theta sub r. If our point is in quadrant 3, our angle is pi plus theta sub r. And if our point is in quadrant 4, theta is going to be equal to 2 pi minus theta sub r. Our first example is the point 5, 12. Let's make a note that this point is in quadrant 1. X is equal to 5, y is equal to 12, and we want to write this point in terms of r and theta. R is equal to the square root of x squared plus y squared. This is the square root of 5 squared, which is 25. Plus 12 squared, which is 144. And this is the square root of 169, which is equal to 13. Since our point is in the first quadrant, our angle theta is going to be the inverse tan of y divided by x. This is equal to the inverse tan of 12 divided by 5. We'll now put that in our calculator. We'll make sure it's in degrees, and we get an answer of 67.38 degrees. Our point in polar coordinates can then be written as 13, 67.38 degrees. If you're finding this video helpful, please give it a thumbs up and consider subscribing to my channel. Our last and by far the hardest example is to convert the point minus 4, 4 to polar coordinates. X is equal to minus 4 and Y is equal to 4. This point is located in the second quadrant, so we'll have to use the reference angle. R is the square root of x squared plus y squared. This is the square root of minus 4 squared, which is 16, plus 4 squared, which is 16. This gives us a square root of 32. That factors into 16 times 2, and the square root of 16 is 4. So this simplifies to 4 root 2. Let's now compute theta sub r. Our reference angle is equal to the inverse tan of the absolute value of y over x. This is the inverse tan of 4 divided by minus 4, which when we take the absolute value reduces to 1. So we have the inverse tan of 1. We know that the inverse tan of 1 is equal to pi over 4, because the tangent of pi over 4 is equal to 1. Because we're in the second quadrant, our angle theta is equal to pi minus theta sub r. This becomes pi minus pi over 4 which gives us a value of 3 pi over 4. Our point can then be written in polar coordinates as 4 root 2, 3 pi over 4. I hope that you now feel more confident in knowing how to convert between polar and rectangular coordinates. In the next video, I'll show you how to convert between polar and rectangular equations. If this video has been helpful to you, please consider subscribing to my channel. Keep believing in yourself and have a great rest of your day.